Hi, my name is Keval Tumaria and this is a quick tutorial on how to install Android operating system on your PC. Let's begin. Now before I begin, I would want you to download two softwares, I mean, one of which is VirtualBox by Oracle, and the other file is the ISO file or the disk image for Android OS. Right, so let's begin with the VirtualBox. You can always download VirtualBox. It's a free software, free to use, from virtualbox.org, and this is the official website, and you can download from the download section, or you might want to just have a look at the screenshots before buying before downloading it. I'm using 64-bit machine, so that's the one for me. For normal users, it's Intel Max. This one is for the normal users, and of course the Linux edition. And secondly, I would want you to download the Android ISO file, which is available at code.google.com/p/liveandroid.com. Sorry, that's just liveandroid/. And there you go. This is the download link from where you can select the ISO or the way by which you wish to download, like with torrent or the split images. I sincerely prefer torrent, and the guys who are using torrent, please see the ISO. Thank you. Once you extract the file or download the torrent, you will see a file somewhat like this if you're using Windows 7. Right, so let's begin. I'll quickly switch on my VirtualBox, and I'll click on new. Next, name would be Android OS or whatever your name is, you can always use it. Now this is a Linux, this is not Linux exactly, but it's based on Linux. It has a Linux kernel in it. 256 MB, yeah, that's right, should be fine, because we are talking about the mobile software, not the actual machine, the computer operating system. This is a mobile phone operating system, and I've already created the Android OS, the hard drive. Okay, I'll quickly show you how to do it. You just need to click on create new hard disk, click on next, click on next. Fixed storage, you have to define the size here. I believe 2 GB is really fine. And oops, okay, I already have it. So okay, once you click on next, it will create the hard disk, the virtual hard disk for you. Click on finish. That's it. Now the first thing that we have to do is we have to mount this ISO file on the machine, I mean on the virtual machine. So this is how we do it. First, I'll go to the settings. Did you see that? Yeah, you have to click on settings. Then you might want to click on storage. This is the hard drive that will be used for Android OS, and it shows empty because I haven't mounted anything yet. So I'll just click on open. To click on add, the location where I have saved my ISO file is on the desktop, so I'll select here. I'll click on open. Once I find it here, select it. And one more thing that I want you to do is uncheck this, enable absolute pointing devices. Yes, I want you to disable it. All right, and I'll click on OK. Once it's done, let's begin. Okay, it's not really rocket science to do it. Okay, 800 by 600 should be fine because it's a mobile software. Does not reports that, yes, does not support, no problem. It's live Android. Now the reason why we have unchecked is because Android doesn't come with the inbuilt pointing device. It relies on your touch, the touch screen, just like how we have here. I'll just click on capture. I'll click here. There you go. That's your Android ISO operating system. Wow. Let's have a look at the browser. Wow, it looks better than the Firefox actually. Let me check if I can play YouTube songs. Okay, it's showing me the mobile editions. Click on play. Might temporarily be down, or maybe move to new address. No problem. Never mind. Oops. Okay, now how to get out of this software will be by pressing the escape key on your keyboard. You just press the escape key and you come back, come out of that. It's just like going backwards. You can play around with all these fancy looking softwares. Wow, it's really nice. Hit the right control on your keyboard to get your original computer mouse back. Now I'll just turn off this part of the machine for this. Thank you for watching. I hope you had a good time. Goodbye.